So, Ajahn, it means that the curfew will be imposed nationwide to try to curb with the virus.
Yes, indeed. I think this is a stepping up in terms of measures to cut the activities at night, to make sure that people who can come out at night are the people who are really have to work in the medical fields, in the production fields, in the communication fields, in the new centers, in the transportation fields. That's to make sure that we are able to control activities at night. This is one of the measures that Prime Minister has warned us a few days ago, and now it will begin to be implemented tomorrow.
And it means that a group of people are still exempted from the curfew, and we can show certificate or letter from our office. Like me, myself, because I will stop working quite late at night, I can still show the letter from the company that I'm really working late night.
Yes, indeed, indeed. I think during the day, I think all agencies and all offices should check with the authority how they can issue, you know, the certificate of permission, how to obtain the permissions from their offices, and they need to coordinate with the police, especially at the checkpoints. In the end, I think that would be the idea. The purpose of this is, of course, to make sure that you don't disrupt, you know, the chains of supply, chain of production. At the same time, allowing only the people who are really need to go out at night, including people with emergencies, people who need to go to the hospital, and other people to move around at night. This is one of the steps of, in the next few days. And we will see more and more of these measures applying in different provinces. Already, Kuthaipachai and Punnatha know very well that in some of the provinces, the measures are even tougher. Their curfews began at 6 in the evening, lasted until 5 in the morning in many tourist areas, for example.
So, Dr. Panitan, what do you think was the last straw that made the Prime Minister believe that he needed to impose the curfew?
Well, a week has passed since the emergency decree has been applied. I think you see a lot of cases of violation, hundreds of violations in various areas, especially people still traveling to get together at night, people still have parties in certain areas. Although majority of the people are now staying at home, they are very much fully cooperative with the government, but the minority of some of these pockets, especially in areas like Bangkok and surrounding provinces, must be controlled more. I think this is one of the purposes. Another purpose is, of course, to allow life to function normally. I think you cannot disrupt the whole society. You cannot break the chains of the production. There will be more crisis if you do that. So in the next days ahead, we will see flexibility on the ground. We will see some confusion, of course, at the checkpoints, as who can get out, who cannot get out. But I hope that in the next few days, things will be much better.
I see. So the curfew will be will be effective until further notice, right? So when,
yes.
So how long do you guess that it will last?
You have three types of evaluation going on right now. One is a daily evaluation, especially in terms of the cases of the infection. That's the daily operations in terms of police arrests, in terms of different productions. They have the daily report to the Prime Minister. And then you have a weekly report on the trend of these activities going up and down. At the moment, the trend is not going down as much as you suggested. And then you have a monthly report that is in line with the limitation of the special decree. If you want to extend, you know, this special decree, you need to get the cabinet approval within a month. Mm-hmm. So we have three different types of evaluations going on at the same time.
See, all these three evaluations will have to be made, I mean, on a daily basis.
Yes, indeed. And of course, this is not complete, but you get the idea. that the country is now moving into a tighter control at the borders, at the border provinces. Incoming trips are now curtailed, including to those Thais who want to return. Now they are facing more tougher measures, as you indicated that there are some of the infected cases bring back from the from abroad. So you see, in the next week or so, you may see more extended, tougher measures in different areas, as you see in certain countries. Certain countries, the curfew are longer than in Thailand. Prohibitions of the public transportation took place in different countries, including Vietnam and other countries. But for Thailand, as Prime Minister indicated just a few minutes ago, the situation is still under control, but very difficult and very tight, you know, a maneuver that we are now doing at a very critical juncture. If you can get this cooperation going on in the next week or so, you can see stepping down in certain areas. People cannot live like this, you know, for years or for months. This is unusual. We are now moving into Songkran festival.
That's
we are
right.
moving into school opening festival, opening sessions. We are
right,
moving
yeah.
into now postpone the conscription of the military, you know, people. We are moving into different areas that for now you cannot do. And that will increase tensions in the household, you know, in the society. So you need to give a take and be more flexible.
And what the case that you can think that will be leading to stricter measure?
Well, I think we are now looking at different groups or clusters or areas that people get infected easily. In certain communities, in certain types of gatherings, in certain type of offices, you need to control more. You see banks are now closing down more and more because their workers are getting infected. And those are the areas that you may need to look closer into the cooperation. Now, today also complaints are now being circulated that some government offices are not closing down as much as they used to. You can see a lot of people still working up. So those have to be more put back under control.
Do you think it may come to a point where the government may need to ask business establishments to consider scaling down their operations so that fewer people will be needed to travel to work?
Well, they have. I think the business sectors, from what we have, the reports, I think they already have a plan ahead of us. But of course, some of the productions maybe need to be open. The government may need to ask them to remain open. So yes, of course, we have different activities, different measures applied. But in general, yes, I think the all activities should be scaled down to the minimum level. But that minimum level has to be discussed among Prime Minister and his advisors and his different sectors that he's now working with.
I see.
Any discussion that perhaps in the near future two people meeting would be banned, or gathering of more than two people will be banned, just like in Australia or in Germany?
Well, Australia is in a difficult situation, although they are now able to control the infection rate down to about 9%. But they're now moving into the winter time, and the winter time is going to be very tough for Australia. They may see more cases rising. So, of course, they need to apply more tougher measures. But for Thailand, we are now in summer. We still have time to work hard before the rain comes. But yes, time indeed is running out if you're not getting things moving.
No, in the past, when we said curfew, the image of soldiers, tough-looking soldiers, fully armed soldiers, standing at checkpoints always came up. So are we going to see that kind of scene this time around?
I don't think you see that. You see more police and volunteers and healthcare workers at the checkpoints, you know, to screen people and to make sure that they're not violating the decree at the moment. For the time being, the police is leading, you know, the operations on the ground with the healthcare workers.
Okay. And I understand that it's a matter of asking people to cooperate. You're not going to enforce the curfew strictly legally, right?
Well,
for the time being, anyway.
This is serious. I think the second order announced a few minutes ago is very serious. But in the beginning, you can see more flexibilities. People may need to go out and to get a letter of certificate, you know, to be verified tomorrow, the day after tomorrow. You can see confusions maybe as who can come out, who cannot come out. But within a few days, I think we need to bring the situation at night under control, and less and less people will be going out at night. And this is serious. If you violate that, you face tough penalties.
And some people say that curfew during the nighttime perhaps not quite efficient because it will block people to come out of home during the nighttime only. But it means that to have daily activity, it will be normal, will probably be the same.
Well, I think you need to begin with the areas or with the time frame that are more easy to apply. And need to make sure that at night there will be no activities, or at least some activities are needed. And then you can move to other time, as some provinces already began applying different time frame. But for the general public, for the whole country, I think this is a signal of things to come. Get people ready, you know, to stay home by order. You know, get people cooperating. You know, for the tougher measures. Once you secure the night, you can begin to think of other time during the day or during different time. But it's the night time that the operation will begin, and they may move on if the measures are not successful. Let's hope that they are more successful, and we don't need to expand more, you know, obvious curfew time.
So that means that you're not dismissing the possibility of the curfew hours being extended, right? If things don't improve as what expected.
Well, that is the indication that Prime Minister gave from the beginning, that we are now moving into the steps and series of measures, you know, from a general cooperation to an order, a stricter orders. Now we are just beginning to move from the first order to the second order. You may see more coming in the Bangkok and surrounding areas. And this is one of the most, you know, infected areas. Mm-hmm. And now the south, also three borders is on the provinces in the south, the deep south. And then you can see the east, the eastern coast. You know, some of these regions may face, if not already facing tougher measures. In Chonburi, they have more tougher measures than Bangkok.
I understand that many or most of the high-ranking officials and personnel at the government house are now working remotely, working from home, right? Is it something difficult for these people to work under this very extraordinary and demanding situation, not to be physically present at the government house to run the show?
Well, it is indeed a challenge for a lot of people, including government officers, but things can be done from home. And then we have many, many good people still working, still healthy. Prime Minister, you know, and the team is still committed. You know, I think we are not affected in general by these. But of course, individuals, regrettably, they need to be quarantined. But of course, they will come out, you know, and then we'll keep fighting. I think we wish for the best for them.